Hey guys, welcome back to the Wild Doc Project 365, episode 157. Today what we're talking about is lateral foot pain that happens during or after squatting activities. You know, there's a whole bunch of different reasons why this can happen. We can go into ankle mobility and knee problems and all these other things, but one thing that we see that happens often, especially as we get out of high school sports and get onto the regular lives, or our adult lives, I should say, is a rigid foot, and more specifically, a rigid forefoot. So let me bring you over here real quick, and we're gonna just kinda talk about some anatomy first here. When we look at the foot, we could basically divide it into two pieces, right? If we look at it and we divide it this way, we can call this portion the rear foot, and this portion the forefoot, right? It's kinda like that. Now, when we look at it this way, that's what we're talking about when we talk about having rigidity in the forefoot. We're lacking, okay, the mobility to come side to side here or work in the coronal plane. So what happens here is during, if you have good squatting technique, right, what'll happen is our knee will have to transverse outward to allow our pelvis to drop down in and hold that good squat position, right? Now, you can imagine if we have a nice supple forefoot, these fingers will, or these digits will stay splayed out onto the ground, and my knee will be able to transverse out correctly, and I won't get any issues here in the foot. Now, if I have a very rigid foot, what'll happen is we'll put these kind of these forefoot digits together. What'll happen is as my knee splays outward, my foot comes up, and now I get compression on the lateral aspects, on the lateral joints of the foot. And after a while, this can become irritative enough where it gives us issues. So how do we do this? There's a couple ways that we can mobilize this. What we really wanna do is we wanna create a shearing force between the digits of the foot. And we can do this a couple different ways. You can take a 2.5 pound plate or a 5 pound plate. I just grabbed a book here because I don't have one with me. But the object is that you're gonna get a surface that's somewhere about an inch or so long, or an inch or so wide, inch or so high. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna start to the lateral side of the foot, okay, and you're just gonna place one digit on at a time. And once you place the one digit on, you're gonna be able to kinda put your thumb over the next digit overwards, and you're gonna be able to create this shearing force just by pressing your knee over top of your toes, right? So that this digit will come upwards, the most lateral one, and the ones that are falling off the book or a weight will shear downwards, okay? And as we move over, we're gonna move over one each time, right? Now we can go through this several times depending on how rigid our foot is, okay? Each time we're just gonna move one over. Say we don't have a book or a 2 pound weight. We can use our hands the same exact way. We just bring all four fingers underneath, and we're just gonna try to support one digit at a time, okay? We're trying to feel for the heads or the metatarsal bases, those little knobby things on the bottom of your feet, right? And we can do the same exact thing, except all I'm gonna do is scooch my finger over one at a time, okay? Now, once we do that, and we get towards the end of the foot, or as we're working lateral to medial, as we kind of come across the foot, we can collapse our other foot, with our other hand, we can collapse the top or the first digit down, and we can just create this rocking motion where we pull up, right? At the same time, we can lean overward, over to the outside of our foot, and really create some shearing and some torquing force into that foot. Basically, what we're trying to do is we're trying to create mobility in this direction. The more supple this area is, the less compression that we're gonna get as we go into those squatting positions. Guys, I hope that makes sense for you today. And until tomorrow, we are optimizing function to optimize performance.